Hello guys, you're back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2004 guys. Okay, so the given question is consider three IP networks. Okay, so they give three networks A, B, C. Okay, so they told it A, B, C. Host HA in network A. Okay, so basically there is a host HA in a network A. Sends a message each containing 180 bytes of application data to HC. Okay, so from here to here, I want to send some data, which is of 180 bytes. 180 bytes of application data to the host B. Okay, so the TCP layer prefixes a 20 byte header to the message. Okay, so basically they are saying TCP header will be of 20 bytes. Okay, so this passes through the intermediate router B. Okay, so the maximum packet including 20 bytes IP header in each network is, so basically including everything, so the size allowed is this guys. So this network A will allow 1000 bytes, network B 100 bytes, and network C 1000 bytes. Okay, so the network A and B are connected through a 1 Mbps data link, while B and C are connected with a 512 Kbps beta link. Nice. Assume that the packets are correctly delivered. How many bytes including header are delivered to IP layer at the destination of one application message in the best case? Consider only data packets. Okay, so they are asking how many data packets or how much data size. So assume that the packets are correctly delivered, how many bytes including header, so basically they are including the header, are delivered to the address, to the IP layer at the destination of a one application message. Okay, so for one application, in best case, how much data is required is there, is what they are asking. Okay, so what did they give clearly guys? Okay, so they clearly told that, so 180 bytes is our data, right? So the data which we want to send. Okay, and on this data 20 bytes will be our header, and again on this whole thing the IP layer will again add 20 bytes. Okay, so in total the maximum size could be around 220, right? Yes. Okay, so it is around 220. Okay, so this much data we want to send indirectly, right? Yes. So but a small issue here is, okay, so they told that the speeds are 1 Mbps and 2 Mbps, right? Okay. Okay, so let us assume in this way guys. Okay, so how we can send guys? So basically they clearly told that 20 bytes is the additional charges, and basically this whole thing also cannot be sent in one single shot, right? Yes. Okay, so let us assume this whole packet has started here. Okay, so let me just take this stick note again. So assume that this is the whole packet which has been started here. Okay, so here it will go easily because the speed is 1 Mbps. But when it comes to here, it is a 512 Kbps. So basically, I need to break this packet into multiple pieces. And similarly, one more important thing is the network A can travel, can send 1000 bytes, whereas network B can send only 100 bytes. So basically, this whole length, which is of around 220, including the header, so basically 200 is our data, right? Yes. So I can store this 200 data in this 100 pieces. Okay, so how can I do it guys? So I am having how much amount of data? 200 bytes of data. Okay, so now I need to fit this into this 100 bytes data. But if you recall, in this 100 bytes also we are having header, right? So they told that it clearly. So in each network, the maximum packet including header, so this is including header, so how much data you can send basically in B? So in B, you can send the data only 80. So if we can send 80, so in first packet, so assume that my first packet is there. So in that, I will send 20 bytes header and then 80 bytes data. So now how much is left more? 120 bytes. Okay. Similarly, in the next second packet, I will again send the header with 80. So again, how much is left? I think around 40, right? Yes. So again, I will send 20 bytes with the header and 40. So here, anything left? No, zero. So with the help of three different packets, I can send my data to this particular network, right? Got it? Yes. So the main thing is here, rather than speed, it directly depends on the sizes, right? Yes. Okay, so now you got an idea, right? Yes. So now what are they exactly asking is, what is the total amount of data which is received by C, including headers? So it is nothing but this total, right? So 80 plus 20 plus 80 plus 20 plus 40 plus 60. It is a 200 plus 60. That is a 260. So D will be the correct answer. Got it? Yes. It's a quite interesting question, right? It's a type of logical puzzle type of question, right? Yes. Okay. So this question is also having a part two, guys. It is a two-parter question. So let us continue with the next question. Okay, just give me a second. Okay. So this is the second question. So the second question is, what is the rate at which the application is transferred to host C, ignoring errors, acknowledgements and everything? Okay. So now they are asking that thing. And did they change any kind of parameters here, guys? I think nothing has been changed, right? Yes. So they are asking what is the rate at which the application data is transferred to host? Okay. Okay, so let us start the calculation. So basically in the network where we are having the minimum speed, guys, because assume that you started sending some data. Okay, so initially it is 1 Mbps, so the data will go really fastly to here, but again here it need to be slowed down, right? So that is the reason why whenever you are solving these type of problems, always take the minimum value as the speed. Okay, yes. So let us start. So how much data or how much MB of data we want to send, guys? How many bytes of data? So we want to send a total of 180 bytes of payload, right? If you recall, that is given here. Okay, 180 bytes of payload. Okay, but how much we are sending at the end, guys? If you recall in the previous question only, we have calculated. So we are sending 260 bytes of data, right? Yes. So basically what will be our transfer rate and everything, it is nothing but this by this, right? Yes. So it is nothing but 180 bytes divided by 260 bytes into our value, which is nothing but 512 KB. Okay, so I think mostly we'll be getting result in this only. So KB is already in all options. So I can just strike this off. Bytes will cancel. Okay, so now let me bring down the calci. So it is 180 divided by 260. Okay, so that is nothing but 0.6 something. So into 512. Okay, so the final result is approximately 354.46. 354. Okay, so option B is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So it's a quite easy question, right? So now you got an idea, right? So what exactly is the rate or ratio? So basically it is same thing like efficiency only, guys. So here what we calculate is throughput only. So basically it is nothing but the useful data by the total data into the bandwidth. Got it? Yes. So now you got an idea, right? Yes. So these type of questions are easy, guys, but the approach which you are going is really important. Got it? Yes. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.